Please subscribe to this YouTube channel Mentor Talk and do press bell button for notifications.
7th October 2020 was thought by many as a day of huge relief for Rhea Chakraborty as she got bail from the Bombay High Court in a serious drug case alleged to be made out by the Narcotics Control Bureau, the NCB, under the NDPS Act, the Narcotics, Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act 1985. But personally, you know, I do not think it was a day of huge relief as has been, you know, displayed to be. It was a day of limited relief, I would say. A day of regret as her brother Showik's bail got rejected by the same court, the Bombay High Court. And he continues to be inside the jail, still inside the jail for some serious concerns. When the charges and case against both the brother and sister appear to be, you know, identical, similar, or perhaps they are actually, then why did the Bombay High Court weigh and consider these two cases on different footing? Why the court granted bail to Rhea but not to Showik, when actually Showik was walking the path, according to me, the path of alleged drug dealing on the asking of his sister Rhea to meet the needs of drugs of her boyfriend or live-in companion Sushant Singh Rajput. Let us discuss why the Bombay High Court granted bail to Rhea but not to her brother Showik. I'm going to, you know, explain the whole scenario in layman's terms, you know, in simple terms, so that the situation and circumstances are well understood by people from all walks of life, you know, especially non-lawyers. It is, you know, NCB's case that both Rhea and Showik allowed their residence for drug storage and they procured drugs for the consumption by Sushant Singh Rajput. According to NCB, they not only regularly dealt in but also financed illicit trafficking of drugs, and they were, you know, conspirators with other accused in the offense involving commercial quantity of contraband, that is LSD, which was allegedly recovered from one of the co-accused, Anuj Keshwani. The NCB claims that they have ample material, including electronic evidence, revealing that both brother sister were involved in drug trafficking. They had facilitated the drug deliveries and payment through credit cards, payment gateways for the contraband. More specifically, NCB alleges that Showik Chakraborty was facilitating, dealing, financing and receiving the drug deliveries at his residence or at their residence and at the residence of Sushant Singh Rajput. If one was to analyze the NCB's case, it is very clear that it has been also stated actually in NCB's affidavit that there was sufficient material against Rhea to show that she was involved in financing the illicit trafficking of drugs and was dealing in drugs. And she was aware that Sushant Singh Rajput was engaged in consumption of drugs and yet she harbored him and concealed him, you know, while he was engaged in consuming drugs. So Sushant Singh Rajput was, according to NCB, the main culprit, sadly, a kingpin of drugs or a recipient of drugs or user of drugs or consumer of drugs. NCB did not claim that Sushant Singh Rajput became addicted to drugs only after Rhea came into his life. He was already addicted to drugs, according to the analysis of the case. The Bombay High Court granted bail to Rhea, perhaps keeping that also at the back of its mind. But the main grounds why High Court granted bail was, one, it concluded that giving money to another for consuming drug would neither mean encouraging such habit, nor would mean financing or harboring as envisaged under Section 27A of the NDPS Act. On some occasions, she had used her own money in procuring drugs. She facilitated, you know, procuring of drugs through her brother. For that purpose, employees of Sushant Singh Rajput were also used. Thus, the court felt that her acts would not fall under Section 27A of the NDPS Act, which deals with, you know, financing illicit traffic of drugs and harboring offenders. Two, you know, the court felt that main section which could be attracted in her case at the most, you know, would be violation of Section 8C, you know, of the NDPS Act, which deals with situations like, you know, producing, manufacturing, possessing, selling, purchasing, transporting, warehousing, using, consuming, import, export of, you know, narcotics, drugs or psychotropic substances. If that be so, it is necessary for the investigating agency to show that her activities or contravention, you know, involved, you know, commercial quantity of a narcotic drug or psychotropic substance so as to qualify the offense as cognizable and non-bailable under the NDPS Act. The investigation did not reveal any recovery either from Rhea or from the house of Sushant Singh Rajput, of drugs. It is NCB's own case that the drugs were already consumed and hence there was no recovery. They are relying more on the recovery from the co-accused and connecting them with that. Hence, in the absence of commercial quantity and she being not part of the chain of drug dealers and not having forwarded the drugs allegedly procured by her, to somebody else to earn monetary or other benefits, she was, you know, granted bail by the Bombay High Court. But then why not Showik? Well, regarding her brother Showik Chakraborty, the Bombay High Court found that there were allegations overwhelming that he was in direct contact with drug dealers. Monetary transactions were reflected in his account. He was facilitating procurement of drugs from one party for supplying them to Sushant Singh Rajput. He was clearly involved in illicit trafficking or, let's say, illegal trade of drugs. The court observed that and considered his case, you know, different from that of a consumer or an end user. It was felt by the court that he appeared to be an important link in the chain of drug dealers. In effect, he's part of chain of drug dealers, said the Bombay High Court, and unfortunately rejected his bail. Now, you know, the line of difference in facts between Rhea Chakraborty's case and her brother's case may seem very thin, but it is not so in the eyes of law, especially when one is dealing with the NDPS Act. He may have done these acts or omissions on the asking of her sister and her boyfriend and companion, but he, meaning Showik, had every right and discretion to not to get involved and even refuse to facilitate the drug dealings. So all the youngsters, beware. My advice to all of you is never take things casually and never be complacent when it comes to acts of breach of laws. Be mindful of these realities of life. Thank you.
Please subscribe to this YouTube channel, Mentor Talk, and do press bell button for notifications.